Hi guys. So today we're going to look at some different parts of polynomial functions. We're going to look at a graph to start, just to kind of define what some of these parts are. Then we're going to look at how to find them on a calculator for some different polynomial functions. So the two biggest things we're going to look at is where a function is increasing and decreasing. But in order to figure that out, we're going to learn something new. We're going to look at something called local extrema. Okay. So what these are on your graph, you'll sometimes see them referred to as turning points, because it's where your graph starts. Instead of going up, it starts going down. So the turning point is another word for a local extrema. Local extrema break down into two different parts. You can have a local minimum, or you could have a local maximum, and we're going to find both of those. Now, the reason that we're calling them local is because it's not the maximum of the total graph or the minimum of the total graph, but it's the minimum within a certain area of points. So what these are really going to be are local minimums and our local maximums. These turning points, okay, are also going to be just the tops and bottoms of curves. Okay, these are the tops and bottoms of curves. Now, on a polynomial function, the most of these turns you could possibly have is one less than the degree of the polynomial. So, for example, this polynomial here could not be a third degree polynomial because it has four turns in it. Okay, so for example, if I have something like x squared plus x minus 2, the most turns that could have would be 1, which we know it has. It's a parabola, so it's only going to have one possible turn. I don't know why I made that into an A, but one turn at the most. Something to the fifth degree, okay, something like that to the fifth degree, that could have up to four turns, okay? So this right here could be a fifth degree polynomial. It doesn't have to have that many, but that's just the most that it could have. Okay, it's just the maximum possible. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to find these local extrema, the local minimums and the local maximums on my graph. Okay, so we'll start by finding a local maximum. Okay, this negative 3, 2, that is a local maximum on my graph because that point right there is the highest point within all the range of points around it, okay? So it's not the highest overall because, as you can see, that graph keeps on going on for forever, so there's going to be higher points. But within that area, okay, within all these points near it, it's the highest point. So it is a local maximum. Now, the actual maximum, okay, since we're talking about highest and possible, highest, farthest up it's going, the actual maximum value is the y value, okay? But the x value is where it happens. Okay, so the maximum is 2, but where it happens is at negative 3. So that's how I'll write it. I'm going to say that we have a local maximum of 2, and that is located at the location of x equals negative 3. So the actual value of it is 2, but it's happening at negative 3. Okay, if you look, there's another local maximum here, another top of a curve at the point 2, 1. Okay, so the value of the maximum is 1, and that is occurring when x is equal to 1. And by 1, I mean 2. Wow, sorry about that, guys. So we have a maximum of 1 when our x value is equal to 2. All right, we also have two local minimums on our graph. Okay, the first one is going to be right here at negative 1, negative 3. Because it is the smallest possible value, again, within that a certain range of points. Now, it's not going to be the lowest for the entire function, because, again, that graph keeps on going for forever. There will be lower total points. But in this area, okay, out of all the points that's near it, it is the minimum value. So the minimum value there that we write is the y value of negative 3. And then we say where that occurs, and that occurs at x equals negative 1. Another local minimum would be over here at 4, negative 1, because again, that's the lowest point for the points around it. That's occurring, the value of that minimum is negative 1, and that's happening when x is equal to 4. Now, the turning points in these local extrema, they're also important because they help us figure out where our graph is increasing and decreasing. Okay, so you may have seen this before. Increasing is if I look left to right in this graph and I follow the path of this graph, are my y values getting bigger or smaller as I keep moving to the right? So as my x's keep increasing. So if I follow this graph, as my x's keep going and I'm tracing that graph, I can see my y values are getting larger as my x's are getting larger. So that means at that point, my graph is increasing. Okay, so I'm going to label a couple other spots in this graph where it's increasing. Okay, right here, this graph is increasing. And then right here, all the way on forever, that graph is also increasing, okay? Because as my x's get bigger, my y's are getting bigger. Now, to list where a graph is increasing, we're going to use interval notation, and we're going to list the range of x values where this is happening. So we're not going to list the y's because we know since it's increasing, we know the y's are going to be getting bigger. But we're going to say where this is happening, so we're going to write the x values, okay? So to write those x values, we're going to use interval notation. So it was everything to the left of my turning point, everything to the left of my local maximum. So these x values would be from negative infinity to negative 3. And we're going to go ahead and put brackets on the negative 3, but we're not going to do that in infinity because you can't touch infinity. Then we've got another section where it's increasing. Again, we're going to list this in interval notation. We're going to go ahead and use brackets, and that is from negative 1 to 2. And again, these are the x values where this is happening. Okay, these are the x values. And then finally from 4 to infinity. Okay, so those are the x values. That tells me where this graph is increasing. Not by how much, that's not what we're listing here. We're just saying where this is happening. All right, so now we're going to list where this graph is decreasing. Well, the graph is decreasing on this other part. Okay, so in between there, as my x's get bigger, as my graph moves to the right, the y values are getting smaller. So my graph is decreasing on these intervals. And we would say this was from negative 3 to negative 1, and from 2 to 4. This graph is decreasing. My 2 does not want to draw. Okay, so that's where my graph is decreasing. All right, so when it comes to writing your local mins and maxes, we're listing the y value and we're saying where it happens. Increasing and decreasing, we're using interval notation to show where these things are happening on my graph. All right, then the last thing we have listed on there is just our end behavior. We've talked about this before, but this is a pretty good review. So end behavior, we're going to look at the limit as x approaches infinity for my function. So as my x's keep getting bigger forever, 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 what are my y's doing? So as my x's keep getting bigger, my y's keep getting bigger, which means this is approaching infinity. Okay, then I look at the limit as x approaches negative infinity for this graph. As my x's keep getting smaller for forever, then my graph is approaching negative infinity. And that would be my end behavior. Okay, the last thing we're going to look at is how to find these values on a calculator. So we're going to look at a function where we don't have these turning points labeled for us. Okay, so we're going to look at this function. So we're going to get the calculators and graph this, and I should already have this set up. Okay, so there's my graph. And then if we look at our window, we're going to make our window a little bit bigger because you can tell there are two turning points here, but I can't see that second one very clearly. So I'm going to go to my window, and it looks like I need to make my y min smaller because my y min is not going to show the bottom of this graph. So let's go ahead and make that a negative 15, and hopefully that'll be enough to see it. All right, there's a local maximum and there's a local minimum. So before I find increasing and decreasing, I'm just going to find my local minimum, my local maximum. Okay, so again, we can identify there's one of each of those. This point right here, that's going to be my local maximum. Because even though it's not the highest total point, it is the highest point of those points around it. And then this point down here, we're going to find that's going to be our local minimum. All right, the way we're going to find this, we're going to use a function on our calculator. You've probably used this before, maybe back in Algebra 1 when you were looking at parabolas. But I'm going to go to second, trace, and then to find the maximum, I'm going to pick maximum. To find the minimum, I'm going to find minimum. So let's do the maximum first. So that's number 4. It says left bound, So I'm going to move my cursor to the left. It just has to be anywhere to the left of that point I'm trying to find. Okay, so it doesn't matter if it's here or here. It just matters as long as it's to the left. Press enter. Then it says right bound. So I'm going to scroll to the right of that highest point. And again, it doesn't have to be even. It just needs to be to the right of that point. It says yes. We're going to press enter again. And it's going to give us our maximum value. So this maximum value, remember, the y-coordinate is the actual maximum. Okay, the maximum here is a negative 1.52. And that is occurring at the x value, negative 0.67. Okay, now we're going to find our local minimum. So same process. The only thing we need to make sure we do, when we get a second calc, we need to actually choose minimum this time, which is number 3. So we're going to scroll somewhere to the left of this point. So I'm to the left of it. It says right bound. So I'm going to go over to the right of this point. Yes, I'm going to press enter. And the lowest point in that range is right there. So the coordinates at that point, the lowest value, my minimum is a negative 11. And that's occurring when x is equal to 2. All right, and then if I wanted to find my values where it was increasing and decreasing, again, I would look at my x values. This graph is increasing from negative infinity until that negative 0.67, and it's increasing from 2 to infinity. This graph is decreasing from negative 0.67 to 2. That is where this graph is decreasing. And so using those points on the calculator, I can find increasing, decreasing, and my local minimums and my local maximums.